Have you ever wondered what powers one of these agricultural giants? If so, you're in luck. We happen to have one with an engine failure. Over the next 4 weeks, we're going to be looking at this thing from the inside out. As you can see, we've got the engine out. We've been busy. Decided to spare you the details. It's pretty self-explanatory. You take bolts out until the thing falls apart. Now let's get inside and have some fun. All right, so we've got the engine inside here. It's disassembled. The next step is going to be to clean and inspect all the parts. Find out what needs to be replaced. What we're going to be using to clean these parts is brake wash and a spray gun. We'll also be using this parts cleaner. It's basically mineral spirits. It recycles it through, pumps it on my parts to clean them. I got some timing gears here, engine oil pickup tube, and the engine oil pump. What I'm going to do is clean these parts up, disassemble this pump, check it for wear. We're going to inspect these pump gears for wear. There's a little bit of wear, but they look pretty good. We can reuse these. We're also going to inspect these bushings. What you're looking for is scoring. This bearing is good. We can reuse it. We need to pull the piston out. So we're going to remove the cap, the spring, and the spool. This is the oil pressure relief valve. It regulates the engine oil pressure and your lubrication system. What we're looking for here is some scoring on the surface of this spool. This does have some scoring, so we will replace this. This engine oil pump is a gear type pump. You got the main housing, the inlet, the outlet. As these gears are driven, they draw in one side, expel out the other side, lubricate the engine. So we've got all of our parts cleaned, inspected, and ready to go back together with this engine oil pump. We're just going to make sure and lubricate all of our bearings. We've got our engine oil pump assembled. Now let's go look at our camshafts. So we've got a cam set up on the bumper on the cam stands. We're going to give it a good cleaning, inspect it. Now we've got the cam good and clean, it's time to inspect the cam journals. What we're looking for is grooves in the journals and in the cam lobes. I don't see any uneven wear on the cam lobes, and the journals are good and smooth. What I have here is a dial indicator. I'm going to use it to check the run out of this cam. That's going to tell us if this cam is true or shaped like a banana. What I'm doing now is I'm setting this up on the cam. This is magnetic. I'm going to sit it on the center cam journal. I'm going to tighten all these clamps so it's set tight. I'm going to zero it, rotate this cam 360 degrees, and let us know in thousandths how much run out we have. All cams, according to the length, have different tolerances. After checking this cam out, it sits at about 6 thousandths run out, which is a miracle, seeing as how our camera guy, Justin Newman, knocked it over. This is the injector cam, basically the same as the valve train cam. Only difference is, you only have one lobe per injector. These big diesel engines have replaceable cylinder liners, so in the event of a failure, they can be replaced individually. You'll notice a buildup of carbon around the top of the cylinder liner. It's important to clean that off. Be gentle when cleaning the outside of this liner. There's an oxide coating that prevents cavitation. Cavitation occurs when vapor bubbles get trapped in between the cylinder liner and the block. This little spot of cavitation doesn't call for a replacement of the cylinder liner. This can be treated with coolant additive. When you're inspecting the inside of this liner, you're going to look for uneven wear or hot spots. This liner looks good. We should be able to hone this liner. The reason that we're honing the cylinder liner is so that the new rings will seat and create a better seal. You want to use mineral spirits or solvent to hone these with. The key to a good hone job is low speed and keep it moving. We're going to take this nasty, grimy stuff outside. We're going to blast it off with our pressure washer. We got our parts cleaned, inspected. We're going to send the rods out and the cylinder block out to get reconditioned. Next week, we're going to tackle the head. And remember, for your parts and service needs, hit us up at NewmanTractor.com. It's extremely flammable. See that?